at the grocery store. Now, this was understandable when COVID started and there was a shortage of products, but why hasn't your bill come down since then? We sent NBC2's Annalise Garcia to find out.
It really was a perfect storm.
Supply and demand.
At the same time that consumers in Southwest Florida were really worried about the future and ran out and bought every canned good they could find, at the same time, the supply chain for products like canned goods was being disrupted.
Both skyrocketed.
Extremely high and extremely quickly.
At the start of the pandemic.
When you decrease the supply and make it more costly to produce, at the same time that there's an increase in the demand for it, it always drives up the price.
Grocery store owners like AJ felt the change quickly when the vendor he had been buying products from for over 10 years shut down.
So we had to scramble to find other vendors to get product to the store.
He and his team managed to find new vendors.
However, their prices were much higher than what we were accustomed with. So we had a choice, either buy and raise the prices accordingly or leave the shelves empty.
He tells me it was never for his gain.
I had no choice. Not because my bank account is going up through.
These shelves were empty at one point. The owners here at Jack's Market tell me they continue doing what they can in order to keep their prices fair for their customers.
You're not just buying the eggs.
Victor Klar is an associate professor of economics at FGCU. He says that supply and demand issue hasn't gone away.
Once we get back to more of a normal supply chain for products, whether they're locally produced or whether they're sourced internationally, that should really ease prices for consumers, especially since now it seems like COVID isn't going to go away next month.
Do you think we can ever expect to see prices kind of regulate again, or you think that grocery stores are going to keep them where they are?
It's very hard to know what the eventual stable equilibrium situation will be like for economies and especially at the grocery store. But I am assured that once we reduce the uncertainty about how bad this will be and when it will end, then we'll start to see a return to the previous normal in terms of the prices of the goods and services that we used to buy.
Until then, you'll be stuck with a bigger bill balance, while store owners like AJ do some balancing of their own.
To operate a business, you have to maintain a certain margin to pay electric, water, rent, employees, insurances.
In Fort Myers, Annalise Garcia,